Ana, te quiero mostrar a ti y a los televidentes primero el reloj.
A reporter trying to give a flavor of the World Cup is suddenly subjected to its ugly side. Colombian correspondent Juliette González Terán is groped and kissed against her will by a man who takes advantage of the fact she's live on air. She later posted on social media saying, "We do not deserve this treatment. We are equally valuable and professional." And it's not the only example. A Brazilian sports journalist was reporting live from Yekaterinburg when she was forced to dodge a kiss from a passerby. Julia Guimarães shouted that his actions were unacceptable, forcing him to apologize.
Other female reporters have also spoken up about harassment from football fans. These incidents have been condemned here in Russia and abroad, but it's raising questions about sexism in sport, particularly at a time when increasing numbers of women are making their mark in this industry as reporters and match commentators.
At the Diversity House in Moscow, which has been set up to combat discrimination, Mariana Linhan says there's still not enough women in all levels of the game.
The objectification and sexualization of women is really serious. And again, I would say that this links to the way people see the role of women in society. Obviously, we're looking towards gender equality in football as well. We're not there yet. We need more women in positions of power, in the media, more women as coaches, as players, more investment. So there is still a lot of work to do in terms of talking about the role and the representation of women in this field.
And fans we spoke to said the message of the World Cup for them was inclusivity.
We had situations in Australia where we've had female sports commentators had comments made about their attractiveness or otherwise, and I think that's quite inappropriate. It's in a workplace environment, everyone should be treated equally and be able to do their business and to do their work.
They don't deserve that. It's not fair. Respect is the most important thing.
I am from Egypt, and we have in Egypt some female reporters. In the first days, they were knowing nothing about the game, but now they are improving a lot.
It's absolutely crazy. I think there's so much work to do in football, but in all other fields too.
There are more female faces at this World Cup than ever before, and it's hoped it will make millions more women feel welcome in what's called the greatest show on earth. But authorities say sexual harassment has no place in the game. And once the cameras are off, it's those who carry out such attacks who will be the ones forced into the spotlight. Jessica King, CGTN, Moscow.